it is all about modifying, you know, x through p, right? Similarly, you can have pointer to p. Okay, if you want to modify p, I'll show pictorially. This is x and content of x is 5. Since in the definition of p you have initialized that p with address of x is 100, then what happens is, you know, p gets 100 because address of x is 100, and p also will have some memory address, right? Let's say that is 200, because every variable goes to memory, so they will have memory addresses, right? And this is p. What I want to say is, I want to have a pointer to p. Whenever you want to have pointer to p, then you need a box, and let's say that box may be anything, its address is 200, whatever, but you should point from here to here, right? To point from p to x, content of p should be, you know, address of x. Similarly, to point from here to here, content of this variable, new variable, should be address of p. Okay, so that is what I write. So how I create now new pointer, you see. So this is, let's say we give a variable name ptr. Okay, so I want a variable, let's say ptr, and it should point to dash object. So tell me the type of the object you want to point. Integer pointer, isn't it? Yes. So this is the type of the object, int star. So you want pointer to dash. See, ptr is a variable and it is a pointer to dash integer pointer. That's why the syntax is int double star ptr. Understand? So whenever you want to have a pointer to integer pointer, you write int double star. Okay, equal to, and in that, do you want to initialize anything? So whenever you write like this, what happens is this kind of variable will be created, but this linking will not be done, right? Because your compiler cannot guess that. So there may be hundreds of variables in your program, and how do your compiler knows that this box should be linked to this? That's why. So that won't happen automatically. We should do explicitly. How to do that? If you really want to link here to here, simply pictorially we should write here 200. Let me do that in programming terms. Programmatically, it is simply writing equal to dash 200. But in, remember one thing, in programming we can't explicitly mention the memory addresses. Of course, even you don't know them, right? That's why it is our just logical imagination. You tell me what is 200 with respect to variables we have. With respect to variables, is it not, you know, address of p, correct? Yes, with respect to p, this is address of p. That's why simply erase it and write address of p. Either you can do like this, otherwise in two steps. What are the two steps? One is create a variable separately, like int double star ptr. Second step is ptr equal to, that means content of ptr equal to dash address of p. So this is the second way of doing the same thing. Okay, now in that way we can create double pointer. The purpose of double pointer is to modify single pointer. Of course, we can also modify this x. How? I will tell you. Before that, please learn some properties of that double pointer. Whenever you have double pointer like this, okay, then the various syntax you can use, I will tell you. First thing is, as usual, every variable can be referred with variable name ptr. Second one, you can also refer address of that box. That's why ptr is, you know, valid, address of ptr valid. Since it is a pointer, dereferencing is possible. Then star comes into the picture, we can write star ptr. This is the third valid thing. There is one more valid thing, that is double star ptr. I will tell you what is double star ptr. So before that, we'll see first 1 and 2. What is ptr at this moment, after this lot of connections? So ptr is content of ptr 200, and address of ptr, what is the ptr box address? 300. Now star ptr is nothing but, you simply imagine like this, star of, just replace variable name with dash, always content of ptr, right? So what is content of ptr? 200. Now it is like star 200, value at memory address 200. Blindly go to 200 box and write value at that. What is value at that 200? 100. That's why this will be 100. So what is 100 actually? 100 is a content of p. Indirectly, this is address of x, isn't it? Now we'll see fourth one, double star PTR. It is also valid. I will tell you the purpose of double star PTR. Double star PTR 2 generally is used to refer X. Okay. So for that, we'll see what happens. Already I told you what is star PTR, correct? So your compiler first evaluates star PTR, then you get 100. So we have to understand what is the remaining star. So this is called dereferencing two times. Generally, double pointers can be dereferenced two times. What happens, we'll see. So value at 100. Go to value at 100. Yes. There is a meaning for it, isn't it? Value at 100 is meaningful thing. That's why double star is given to double pointers. That's why it is value at 100. Value at 100 is 5. Always star means value. At dash, given memory address. Is it not memory address? Yes, that's why it is valid. But don't ever use star with integer. Okay, this is absolutely false. The reason, so star is, you know, trying to refer address, right? So that's why always star goes with address. Without address, how can I go and take the value? That's why value at integer is absurd, otherwise not meaningful, invalid. So these are the various things. Similarly, you can have fourth pointer like int, triple pointer, sorry, int star star star, like maybe pointer. Already pointer is used, then we use like, you know, p1. Then you know the syntax of p1. So if you want to link p1, then you can link it to double pointer like this. p1, what is the syntax for that? Of course, p1 equal to address of ptr and everything same. Then you can have five kinds of, you know, syntax. One is p1, second one address of p1, third one star p1, double star p1 and triple star p1. Okay, in that way you can link all these things. Okay, so what is the purpose of double pointer, we'll see. Okay, so for that I take a story. Raju is an integer and he is having a value 5. Okay, Raju is a memory box. Int Raju equal to 5, that's why. So Raju is, let's say, 100. Now Maharaju is a king and Raju is son of Maharaju. Okay, then Maharaju always take care of Raju. For that, so int Maharaju, it is Maharaju is a pointer, then that pointer always have address of Raju, let's say. Same thing I am doing with some story. Okay, now int double star Chakravarti. So Chakravarti is, you know, a very big king and he is father of Maharaju, and usually he will take care of Maharaju. For that, you know, Chakravarti knows address of Maharaju. Try to understand this story. So Raju is, you know, a boy who is, let's say, you know, a very rich person, and because he is son of Maharaju, that's why always Maharaju points to Raju, so that, you know, to keep track of what Raju is doing, everything. Okay, so how to understand this one is Raju is here. Okay, now Maharaju here, MR, let's say, for shortcut. Then Chakravarti is nothing but CB. So what happened because of all these three syntax, we'll see. Raju's value is 5 and let's say memory address is 100. Then Maharaju is getting address of Raju. Address of Raju is 100. Let's write 100 here. Then Chakravarti is having address of Maharaju. Let's say address of Maharaju is 200. Then content of Chakravarti is 200. Let's say address of Chakravarti is 300. Okay. So logically, it's like there are mappings like this, links. Now, what is the purpose of this double pointer, single pointer and variable, we'll see. Example, you Raju want to change his mind. This is, let's say, his mind. Okay. So the content of Raju is nothing but it's because of his mind. So he want to, you know, change his mind. Okay. For that example, Raju want to buy a car. Buying a car for him is nothing but changing it, his value to 6. Then how to do that? There are three things. One is Raju equal to Raju plus 1. Okay. Yes. Second one, we can do indirectly. Example, Maharaju want to change Raju's mind, but Raju should not know that. Okay. For that, what we can do is, so in the place of Raju, we know the relationship between Maharaju and Raju. Since Maharaju equal to star Raju, isn't it? Sorry, star Maharaju equal to Raju, isn't it? We know that already it is. Check it out. star. What is Maharaju? Always a variable name is content of the box. 100, right? Star 100 equal to, okay. So Raju, what is content of Raju? Content of Raju is 5. Check it out whether it is correct or not. Star 100, value at 100. Yes, 5. Correct. That means from now onwards, either I can use Raju, otherwise in the place of that, I can use star MR. Okay. Then this will become star MR equal to Raju. In the place of Raju, always I can use star Maharaju plus 1. That is equation number 2. Third one. There is a relationship between Chakravarti and Maharaju. You see, star 200, just observe star 200, you will realize everything. So value at 200 is dash. Value at address 200 is dash 100. Correct? Are they not equal? See, star 200 is 100, but star, what is 200? Content of, I mean, whenever I say 200, it is nothing but variable name, right? CV. That means content of CV equal to 100. 100 is what? This one. Is it not content of Maharaju? Then we can replace with MR. So from now onwards, star CV equal to MR, right? So now replace. Whenever you see MR, you write star CV. Okay, I write it star MR can be replaced with star CV, so that will become double star CV. Similarly, star MR will become what? Double star CV plus 1. In that way, we can increment Raju using CV, but further syntax is double star CV equal to double star CV plus 1. Okay, so in that way, so you can manipulate single pointer, double pointer, and variable. Okay.